I can tell you that there are actually only two main reasons for a home not selling in a reasonable amount of time. Literally two. You have recently put your home for sale with big plans on using that money for another real estate investment or personal purchase of yours. However, months and months pass and you find no potential buyers. In fact, it seems like people are turning away from buying your home. Why does this happen and how can you avoid this and finally snag a deal with a buyer and sell your home? My name is Balaji Badrinath and today I'll be explaining to you the top reasons why your home is not selling and teach you how to sell it too. Don't forget to subscribe my channel and turn on the notifications on for more incredible real estate tips and tricks like this one. So let's begin. The first thing you should know is that any real estate market in any economy has a handful of homeowners and landlords quite worried about their homes not selling. It's actually quite normal. They find that their houses just sit on the market for months and years and absolutely no one seems to find any interest in them. They eventually become stale inventory and become even more frustrating with every passing day. As an expert in real estate, I can tell you that there are actually only two main reasons for a home not selling in a reasonable amount of time. Literally two. All other reasons could be considered subcategories that originated from the ones I'm going to mention today. First, either the home lacks proper market exposure, and second, the home is not priced appropriately. It's either one or could even be both at the same time, which is much worse. So let's take a look at them and analyze what they consist of. In any kind of business, you need to get your product out to your potential buyers by marketing it directly to them. As easy as this seems on the paper, there is a reason why there's a whole science and professional career behind marketing. You need to expose your home to those that might actually be interested into buying them. One of the most beautiful parts of real estate is analyzing prospective buyer choices when it comes to the home of their dreams. There are certain neighborhoods with many different characteristics and traits depending on which part of the country you live on. For example, if you are marketing a home located in Jayanagar, which is filled with peaceful lanes, lush green trees, and a general tranquil feeling, then you should market it to older families that want to settle down or retire. Their kids might have already left and they simply want a place to enjoy their coming years at a slower pace. That's why many older families in Bangalore have their homes in Jayanagar. However, you will only know this if you understand how your potential buyer thinks. So investigate or research the kind of people that tend to buy properties around the area of your home you are trying to sell. It's not enough with just knowing if they are young people or older people. You also need to know what they eat, what they like to purchase for clothing, and most importantly, what social media channels they are residing in. If they are mostly on Facebook, then market your home on Facebook too. If they are a millennial crowd and they are on Instagram, then do some quick Instagram ad marketing and get your home in front of them. Whichever option you take, if you know what they are doing, what they like, and where they are, then half of your job is already done. The most productive marketing in today's world of real estate is online marketing coupled with strong agent presence. This targeted marketing uses an understanding of the age, financial status, and motivation of the right buyers for each particular home. Highly targeted online marketing can include specialty websites, targeted online ads, and targeted and boosted social media engagement. These tools are almost never free, as you might know. Purchasing ads or putting your home in a specialty website has a cost. Think of it not as an extra expense, but an additional investment in getting word out there. So once you find an interesting buyer, then comes the second part of the deal. The price is very important for obvious reasons. When I mentioned early in the video that some homes are not priced appropriately, I am referring exclusively to the competitive pricing. Competitive pricing doesn't mean a dirt cheap price that you will net you almost no benefit from selling your home. In fact, there are some instances where an underpriced home actually creates problems in the longer term. An appropriate price can be a bit complicated to set, but done appropriately, it will ensure that your home passes hands to another owner, an appropriate owner. A home has to be reasonably priced, taking into account all the factors surrounding it. House condition and age, the local neighborhood, the traffic, nearby amenities such as restaurants, shopping malls and parks, available public things and many other variables that do have an importance in how expensive your home will be in the long term. Smart pricing can help overcome the issue of real estate not selling. People are always thinking of money first and foremost, and pricing can make a home appealing to someone. Remember that first of all, buyers today are savvier than ever. Buyers sometimes even understand pricing strategies better than sellers. Some might not be new real estate owners and have experience on top of that to boot. So if your pricing strategy is inconsistent or doesn't make much sense, then they will notice and avoid purchasing your home, seeing it as overpriced or a scam deal. Buyers today will not be easily fooled when they have so much information at their disposal. Buyers are often much better than sellers at understanding the reality of homes not selling. When setting the price of a home, the smart seller will work hard to think like the informed buyers and avoid price justifications. Another pitfall that you should completely avoid as a seller is to start with a high home price and then undercutting it as time passes by. When a price drop strategy begins, a buyer will be subconsciously convinced into thinking that they can actually keep waiting and see if you keep lowering the price. You may not be willing to lower your price anymore, but they probably don't know this either. So they are going to be waiting for more unless you explicitly establish that the sale price is going to be your final sale. Finally, if your home is classified with a high days on market category, most new buyers will avoid them because they will interpret this as a bad statistic. Repeated price cuts also suggest to buyers that the seller is willing to make a deal. So when buyers finally do decide to make an offer, they will often make a very low offer. The best way to turn this around is to establish a smart strategy from the get-go. When you're setting your price, use current market data to let the buyers believe it's a reasonable one. You can also get the job done yourself and do some real estate improvements to increase both the real and the perceived value of your home. Make sure the house itself is in fantastic condition. It's clean, it smells great, it feels bright, and actually feels like a decent place to live in. These are, of course, additional expenses, but if you are able to increase the price of the home after performing them, then you will actually be getting a return of investment anyway. Be sure to let your buyers know of using the accurate marketing that reflects the real and perceived value of your home. As worrying as it might seem to see your home sit in the market for weeks and months, it's only a matter of strategy. Put your home out there in the eyes of people that will actually want to buy it and also price it appropriately to make sure they don't pass up that fantastic deal. You will see how after changing these two things up, your home will be selling in no time. Anyway, what are your thoughts on these tips for selling your home? Will you be using one of these incredible tips to turn things around and finally sell it? Let me know in the comments below. Also, make sure to leave me a like, share this video with your friends, and subscribe to my channel for more videos like this one. Thanks for watching, and I will see you next time.